Hello students. So in the machine learning lecture series, today we are going to see the brief introduction about the soft computing approaches in the machine learning. What are different soft computing approaches? See, there are two things. The first one is soft computing and second one is hard computing. What is hard computing? When something is belong to some group with 100% membership. For example, you say that this student belongs to that particular class. It means whether he belongs to that class or not belongs to, whether 0 or 1. So it is known as the hard computing. But in the soft computing, there is some membership or the belongingness to some particular case. For example, if I say that the age of this person is 30 and 70% it belongs to the young category and 30% it belongs to the old category. So this is how you can break it down in the most soft measure, so that you can identify that his membership belongs to that particular category or the other particular category. So this is how you can differentiate the soft computing and hard computing. There are different classification methods, just like we have covered the k-nearest neighbor classifier. We have also seen the case-based reasoning, and today we will see the brief introduction about the genetic algorithms, rough set approach and fuzzy set approaches. Genetic algorithm is nothing but an analogy to biological evolution. Here each rule is represented by a string of bits, and the rule is nothing but a chromosome in the human body, or you can say the individual. An initial population is created consisting of randomly generated rules. So in the biological evolution, if you see that there is some initial population, this initial population will generate the new offsprings based on the notion of survival of the fittest. A new population is formed to consist of the fittest rule and their offsprings. So you might have seen the Darwin's theory. What is the Darwin theory? The survival of the fittest. The one who is fit will survive for the more time. Fine. So here there is initial population. The initial population, we will find out who is the more fitter than others. We will select them. And thereafter they will generate the new offsprings or new generation. The fitness of a rule is represented by its classification accuracy. So how you are going to say that this particular individual is fitter than the other one? Through some classification accuracy. You can choose the error formula, just like the mean absolute error. If error is lower, then you can say that this particular chromosome is fit and that is not. There is comparison of the error accuracy. Fine. Offsprings are generated by crossover and mutation. In genetic algorithm, there are two operators. Crossover, which is used to generate the two more offsprings from the two parent chromosomes. And mutation is to mutate some particular bit of a chromosome in order to see the changes. Fine. The second one is rough set approach. In rough set approach, there is something called the roughness. Unlike your fuzzy set, the rough set approach is based on the concept of approximation. Here, the approximation means the roughly. Roughly belongs to that category or the another category. A rough set for a given class C is approximated by two sets. So there are two sets. First is lower approximation, certain to be in C, and an upper approximation cannot be described as not belonging to C. So the one is belonging to C and the another one is not belonging to C. So here in this particular diagram, this particular case here this belongs to the upper approximation for this one, and this is the lower approximation. So lower approximation means for this particular C, it can certain to be in C, right? So this is certainly in the C, this part, and that part is not, cannot be described as belonging to C because some parts are outside or can be outer to this particular C, right? Finding the minimum subset of attributes is NP hard, but a distributability matrix is used to reduce the computational intensity. So this is how you can use this particular rough set approach. However, it is NP hard, but distributability matrix can be used to reduce the computational intensity. The last one is your fuzzy set approach that we are going to discuss. Is fuzzy logic uses truth values between 0.1 to 0.0 to 1.0 to represent the degree of membership, such as using fuzzy membership graph. So what happens over here, you can see in this graph, so there is one fuzzy membership category or the class. The first is low, the medium or high. So if you say that if the income is between 10 to 20, then it will belongs to low class in 100% case, fine. If it is 30,000, then it will certainly in between the low and medium, fine. So here you can see that if the income is 30,000, then it will certainly belongs to the medium class. But if the income is between 20,000 to 30,000, then the some part belongs to low category and some part belongs to medium. So this is not a hard computing, this is soft computing, where the some part of the income belongs to the low and some part belongs to medium. There is no hard membership. Attribute values are converted to fuzzy values. For example, income is mapped into the discrete categories. So there are three categories, low, medium, high, with fuzzy valued values calculated. For a given new sample, more than one fuzzy value may apply. So it is possible that for a simple sample, there is more than one fuzzy value. Each applicable rule contributes a vote for membership in the categories. Typically, the truth values for each predicted category are summed. So if you see, let's suppose the salary is 25,000. So you can see that if 25,000 is there, then 60% belongs to low class, low category, and 40% belongs to your medium category, fine. Now add both 60 and 40, it will become 100. So the truth values are summed up and it will become 1, fine. So the range of the truth values is become 0 to 1. Thank you.